Now we talk about conditional expectation. So here we simply replace probability of a random variable x with conditional probability. So focus on the fact that expectation of a random variable x, this was given as you sum up over the all the values this random variable x takes. This times then probability that the random variable takes on the value of some number small x. Now for conditional probability, you just copy the same formula down, but you just condition it on the random variable y. So we know how to compute this. We have seen an example of this. And for the continuous case, you just replace this conditional density with conditional density in the continuous form. So let us see how this works in an example. So we will take the same density function we had in the previous example. So that is f of x comma y is 1 by y exponential minus y minus x by y if x and y lie in the interval 0 to infinity. That is small x lies between 0 to infinity and small y also lies between 0 to infinity. Again, notice that random variable is capital X and it is a function. So this function is taking on values small x and these values lie between 0 and infinity. So this we computed in the previous example. The conditional probability is 1 by y times exponential of minus x by y. So expectation is, so we use this formula right here. Just copy down this formula. And now instead of this value, we have this value. X times 1 by y exponential minus x by y dx. So you can either use computation by hand or you can use Mathematica or MATLAB. And once you integrate, you get y. So notice that I'm going from 0 to infinity instead of minus infinity to infinity because outside this interval, this density function is just 0. So this is our domain in which we operate is 0 to infinity. So we have 0 to infinity here. So notice that you get a value y. So conditional expectation is a random variable. This is very important. Notice that in case you just had expectation of x, in that case, the way it works is you have integration from minus infinity to infinity, x times f of capital X times small x dx. So if you integrate this, because you're giving proper limits and you're integrating over x, this will be a number. So a constant. This is not a random variable. Whereas here, you're not getting a number. You're getting small y, which you can again integrate with respect to, say, dy. So this is a random variable. So since this is a random variable, you can take its expectation also. And we will see this expectation shortly.